We had been working in the area of natural resource management, which led us to a lot of rural projects as well and interaction with rural communities. And the whole idea was that we felt that the rural consumer was not treated as a consumer as is the way with the urban markets. The idea was to do something, treat the rural population as a proper consumer and provide quality products and services.
A lot of bamboo is being wasted. It is not at all used and not at all harvested by farmer. At the same time, youths are migrating to a city for earning livelihood. So we thought that if we can use this material, at the same time give employment opportunity to the local youths and stop them to migrate to the city, that will be the best proposition.
Masuta literally means MA stands for Mahila, SU stands for Suta means yarn, and TA stands for Tassar. So this is not a Chinese or Korean name. This is a very Indian name. It's an all women owned Tassar yarn producers organization.
The farmers are facing problems in making agriculture profitable. So we thought we should help them. Not only with the advisory, but also with the other services.
We belong to a farmer family. Since the childhood, I have seen the plight of farmers, their life, how the life had been difficult for them, only because they had not had any market access. They could not get access to market. Our farmers are producing very good. They have mastered the art of vegetable production and all, but only thing that they have not been able to master is marketing.
Indian farmers are not getting the value of the total output what they are producing. So we are just trying to eliminate the intermediaries and we are making the best possible to reach to the farmers.
I am a farmer and I am not seeing a problem with farmers. I started my pumps industry in 1990. वो एग्रीकल्चर रिलेटेड ही सबमर्सिबल पंप्स बना रहे हैं, तो हम फार्मर्स के साथ जुड़े हुए हैं। तो फार्मर्स का क्या क्या प्रॉब्लम, क्या क्या उसका कठिनाई, वो सब सामने आई।
काशीम जिला इन 20 आंध्र लो चाला यानकपट्टा 20 प्रांतों आ प्रांतों लो गवर्नमेंट डेयरी इन 20 विजया डेयरी वारो మిల్క్ని హ్యాండ్లింగ్ చేయలేని పరిస్థితులు, మేనేజ్మెంట్ కరెక్ట్గా లేని పరిస్థితుల్లో అక్కడ పల్లెల్లో మరి వారందరూ కూడా మేము రైతు కుటుంబం నుంచి వచ్చినాం కాబట్టి ఇలా మీరు ఒక మంచి పాడి పరిశ్రమ పెడితే బాగుంటుందనే అభిప్రాయంతో వారు మాకు సలహా ఇవ్వటం, రైతులందరూ కూడా ఒక చిన్న పాడి పరిశ్రమ పెడితే బాగుంటుందనే అభిప్రాయంతో మమ్మల్ని ఆనాడు అడగటం జరిగింది. మేము కూడా రైతులం కాబట్టి, రైతు పిల్లలం కాబట్టి మేము ఫ్రెండ్స్గా నలుగురి ఈ ఆ ప్రాంతంలో డైరీ ఇండస్ట్రీ చిన్న పాడి పరిశ్రమ స్థాపించడం జరిగింది.
ఇన్ అవర్ కంట్రీ బాంబూ ఇస్ ట్రీటెడ్ యాజ్ ఇన్ఫీరియర్ చీప్ అండ్ నాన్ డ్యూరబుల్ మెటీరియల్. Internationally, if you see, bamboo products are the premium products. Even though we are the second largest bamboo producing country in the world, our market share in the international market is less than 1%.
There are no tailored products for the rural market, very few of them. Part of the reason is that there is no standardization in the market as such either. If you want to give an electrical product, there is no standard voltage or current that you have in a rural household.
The agriculture sector is undergoing agrarian problems. At the macro level, the problem is due to the fragmentation of the farms and also the vagaries of the monsoon. At the micro level, the farmers are not getting the services in time. Finance is also not available to them. The inputs are inferior quality and they have no market linkage. With the result, agriculture was becoming a problem for the small farmers and they are even started committing suicide. only the government was trying to give some subsidies to solve this problem, but they have not worked in the long run.
ఎంతగానో మరి మాకు అక్కడ సహకరించారు. రైతులు ప్రతి విషయంలో తిరుమల డైరీ అంటే డైరీ అంటే తిరుమల తిరుమల డైరీనే ఈరోజు డైరీగా గుర్తించడం జరిగింది. ఎక్కడ ఉన్నా కూడా తిరుమల డైరీకి ఫస్ట్ ప్లేస్ తిరుమల డైరీకి వాళ్ళు అవకాశం ఇచ్చడం జరిగింది. మరి ఆ అవకాశాన్ని మేము సద్వినియోగం చేసుకొని రైతులు మాకు చేసినటువంటి మంచి సహకారాన్ని మేము కూడా వాళ్ళకి ఏదో విధంగా సహకరించాలనే అభిప్రాయంతో ఎంతగానో కృషి చేసి మేము తిరుమల ఇంజనీరింగ్ కాలేజీ స్థాపించి మొట్టమొదటగా రైతుల పిల్లలకి ఫ్రీ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ చేయాలనే అభిప్రాయంతో మా ఫార్మర్స్ ఎవరైతే ఉన్నారో వారందరికే కాకుండా అదర్ వేద విద్యార్థులు అనే వాళ్ళ ప్రతి ఒక్కరికి కూడా మేము పూర్తిగా మా తిరుమల గ్రూపు సహకరిస్తుంది.
Customers were not knowing from where their produce is coming. Farmers were not knowing who all are taking this produce and what their demand is. So first problem was information gap between farmers and consumer. Second was longer vegetable supply chain. It used to take approximately 24 hours to 48 hours to reach a vegetable produce from farmer's farm to consumer's plate. So it was a longer supply chain. Third was the inefficiency in the supply chain. Everybody was just trying to trade. Nobody was trying to add any value in terms of how to reduce transaction time, how to build in more convenience and more experience for customers, how to provide better input to farmers.
Indian farmers are not getting the maximum value of the produce or the final value what the end user is paying. Infrastructure is one of the basic constraints right now. India is following geography. We are having many multiple locations and it is spread towards semi-urban rural and areas.
Farmers क्या है जो पहले से जो खेती करते हैं वही हिसाब से करते हैं. उसको किसी ने टेक्नोलॉजी बताया नहीं, अच्छी क्वालिटी का इनपुट किसी ने दिया नहीं, और कैसे टेक्नोलॉजिकल फार्मिंग होना चाहिए वो किसी ने बताया नहीं. तो आज तक वही पुरानी ढंग से सब लोग खेती करते थे.
Our entire tassar, weaving sector is mostly dependent on Chinese and Korean imported yarns. So there is a huge gap of yarn in the market, and there is raw materials are available, but those are in the control of middlemen and traders, who the producers, they don't have any control. Large tract of upland, the whole soil is totally denuded, and it's a totally rain fed, very minimum rainfall is received. So that kind of land can be utilized in tassar plantation, and it will generate large number of livelihood in most troubled, otherwise troubled area part of India, where the people are just migrating and then they don't have any income source in their home. At this moment I can say whatever tassar yarn is produced in India, except Masuta, entirely is unorganized, and it's home-based, confined within weavers' family with their women folk. So at present, Masuta is the only organized tassar yarn producers company, which caters at this point I can say no less than around 15 to 20% of total yarn produced. Indian tassar yarn produced is supplied by Masuta.
Bamboo product has a tremendous rural employment capacity. To change the image of a bamboo from poor man's timber to a premium quality products, we should really make available products of bamboo of a really good class in a niche market, so which can definitely change the image of bamboo. Second thing, in our country mostly the population belonging to backward class works in a bamboo. That image has to be changed, otherwise it will be restricted to that particular class. Younger generation has to come into this trade, because they don't find this trade lucrative, and that's why you see only older people working in this sector. And third most important thing is bamboo not utilized, the carbon which is sequestered in the bamboo is coming again into atmosphere and within 5 to 6 years. If we treat bamboo for its longer duration life, then that sequestered carbon will remain in bamboo for longer period, more than 100 years. And no, it will be definitely helping climate change mitigation.
We are in the business of developing rural products and services targeted towards the BOP market. Of course, bulk of our backend is very technical in nature, so we do a lot of technical product development. The idea was to do something, treat the rural population as a proper consumer and provide quality products and services. So our idea has been to work in this non-standard environment and provide good solutions as such. And we have been working towards that.
So there is a gap between the technology providers and the organized sector in the agribusiness. With the result, the local traders and also the local money lenders are exploiting the farmers. So the solution is to bridge the gap. That's what we are trying to do by creating infrastructure of kiosks at the village levels and provide integrated and comprehensive services. The services include agro advisory, continuously from sowing to harvest, providing quality inputs at the farmer's doorstep, connecting them to the market through various channels, providing them finance and insurance services, agro information continuously, and also post-harvest management services.
We have been able to organize more than 3,000 farmers and more than 1,000 vegetable vendors in Bihar. And we have been trying to create a platform, professional platform, where farmers and vendors can directly interact with and by supplying vegetables to customers at very low rate, at reasonable price. In a way, we are trying to give a very unique business model to the world.
हमने कॉन्सेप्ट डिजाइन किया भाई, फार्मर्स को सब जगह पे अलग 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 चीज़ लेने के लिए जाना पड़ता है, तो क्यों वन स्टॉप सॉल्यूशन ना हो, और ये सब अलग अलग जगह से लेने के बाद भी उसको गाइडेंस कहीं मिलता नहीं था। तो हमने ऐसा एक कॉन्सेप्ट बनाया कि भाई वन स्टॉप सॉल्यूशन, एक ही जगह से फार्मर्स को अच्छी क्वालिटी का इनपुट मिले, गाइडेंस मिले, फार्मिंग के में क्या क्या उसका कमियाँ है उसको कोई गाइड करे, और आज जो टेक्नोलॉजी आया है वो हमने दिया तो उससे फार्मर्स को अच्छा बेनिफिट भी मिलता है। नया नया टेक्नोलॉजी, ग्रीन हाउस, वेदर का इंफॉर्मेशन, सॉइल टेस्टिंग, वो सब आज तक किसी ने दिया नहीं था, फार्मर्स ने करवाया नहीं था, वो सब हमने करवाया, अच्छा रिस्पॉन्स है सब जगह से।
एज अ फाइनलिस्ट इन संकल्प फोरम आवर एक्सपेक्टेशन हैज इंक्रीज। We are very sure that we are getting a platform where we will reach to a proper crowd, where a lot of investment can be brought in this business.
Sankalp is an excellent forum for organizations like us, which are into the social sector. The forum forces us to interlink with the other stakeholders in the industry, and most importantly, we are able to access the social capital through the venture capitalists and the angel investors.
I think the Sankalp Forum by itself is a big confidence booster. It gives us confidence in ourselves that yes, there is something right that we're doing. And the way the whole mentoring process, everything has been arranged, we believe that we'll come out much more sophisticated and focused in terms of what we intend doing.
Through Sankalp, we can go in the media and people can know us. Farmer can be more educated about our company and they can also be benefited. So Sankalp is a very good platform according to me, where we can directly reach to our goal audience, especially farmers.
इन्वेस्टर और कॉरपोरेशन का एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, तो ऑब्वियसली वो अवार्ड से हमको फायदा तो मिलेगा इन्वेस्टर का ये, और इन फ्यूचर बेनिफिट तो मिलेगा ही मिलेगा।
మాకు తిరుమల గ్రూప్కి సంకల్ప అవార్డు రావడం మాకు ఎంతో ఆనందంగా ఉంది. ఆ సంకల్ప వారు వచ్చి ఇక్కడ మమ్మల్ని ఎన్నిక చేయడం కూడా వారికి కూడా మా కృతజ్ఞతలు తెలియపరుచుకుంటున్నాం.
ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ వెరీ రైట్ ఆపర్చునిటీ to showcase our business model, to showcase our development model, the work we are doing. One benefit that we are looking to derive out of is to attract investors who can invest in our social enterprise.
Sankalp Forum, actually recently we got entered into this forum. So I used to get lot of information about social enterprise and how it is growing. In few days back there was a debate on whether large scale expansion or there is such kind of issues which actually helps people like me, enrich me intellectually and also help me to know what is happening in some other parts. So it's a good forum to get access to various kind of information related to social enterprise and many such kind of developmental issues.
We are very proud and privileged to be the finalist of Sankalp 2011, and we hope we also win the award.
We at Greenway Grameen Infra are proud to be the nominees of Sankalp Awards 2011.
We at Star Agri are proud to be the nominee of Sankalp Award 2011.
We in Masuta feel proud of being part of Sankalp Award 2011.
We at Campaign Agro Limited proud to be a nominee of Sankalp Award 2011.
We at Native Comeback Bamboo Products Private Limited are extremely happy and excited to be a finalist of Sankalp Award 2011.
We Team Samriddhi, we Team Needs Green are very much proud of to be part of the Sankalp Award 2011, and we are looking forward to have more positive interaction, amicable interaction with Team Sankalp as well as all the members and delegates who would be coming over there. So looking forward to it.